Hey everybody, I'm here today to talk to you about 5 hacks to avoid parking tickets. If you are the type of person, the type of driver that constantly gets parking tickets and it seems like you can't avoid them, you should be watching this video and utilizing these 5 hacks as much as you possibly can. Without further ado, let's get right into the video. Hack number 1 for avoiding parking tickets is to read all signs carefully. Now, there's a difference between intentionally parking somewhere where you know you're not allowed to park and kind of accepting the fact that you might get a ticket versus not knowing that you can't park there. The best way to counteract this not knowing, unintentional parking ticket, we should call it, is to read all of the signs carefully. So look at all of the signs on that street, near the parking spot, further away from the parking spot, across from the parking spot. Just really be observant of all of the signs around you that you can see. Instead of just parking your car, looking beside it and walking away, take a quick walk down the street and up the street and really observe the signs to see if you can park there. And this way, if you see that you can't park there, move your car and you won't get a ticket. Hack number 2 to avoid getting a parking ticket is to put extra time in the meter. Now, this obviously is referring to the parking ticket that you'll get if your time expires, if you are paying for parking within a certain time frame. So if you've paid for half an hour's worth of parking and your time expires and you get a ticket, well, your time expired. So what I always recommend is just put a little bit of extra money into the parking meter, into the parking machine. Give yourself a little bit of extra time because you don't want to be A, rushing back to your car, or B, knowing that your time expired and wondering if you're going to be unlucky enough to get a parking ticket. So just pay the extra couple of bucks to put the extra half an hour or hour in the parking meter. This way you can have a better chance at not letting the time expire and not getting a parking ticket. Listen, if your parking ticket is going to cost you $30, it's worth it to put in the extra $2 into the meter. It's as simple as that. Hack number 3 to avoid getting parking tickets is to read the fine print on your parking permit or the parking lot. In a lot of parking lots, there's gonna be fine print, okay? There's gonna be, your bold print, something that you can see immediately, $20 flat fee. And then there's gonna be a little fine print that might say, flat fee $20 until 8 p.m. Then you must, pay an extra $5 from 8 p.m. till midnight or something like that. If you don't see the fine print, then you can get a ticket because you are parked improperly. Your car is parked where it shouldn't be. So take some time. When you get a parking ticket, not a ticket as in a fine, a parking ticket as in like a permit to park in a certain parking lot. Read it and read the fine print. If you see a sign, a parking sign or a no parking sign, read the fine print. If you see instructions for paying for parking, read the fine print. Hack number 4 for avoiding parking tickets is to make the assumption that parking time limits are enforced. A lot of people will park their car just assuming that no one's going to come by and give them a ticket. That's pretty much the best and easiest way to get a ticket. So with that being said, you really want to assume that the parking time limits and the parking rules are enforced. If it says you are only allowed to park here for 2 hours, you're gonna assume that as soon as you leave there, your timer starts. Don't think, oh, the person probably won't come for half an hour, so then I have about 2.5 hours. Don't think like that, because you might walk back and find a ticket on your windshield, or you might get a ticket in the mail. Instead, make the assumption that the parking time limits are indeed being enforced. Hack number 5, the final one for this video for avoiding parking tickets, is to use public transit or take a taxi. Now, when you use public transit or take a taxi instead of driving, it might cost you a bit more and it might add a little bit of an inconvenient factor for you. But if where you're going, there's no parking and you're risking getting a $30, $40, $50, $100 parking ticket, and not only does that cost you money, the parking ticket, but you have to go pay it, which is an inconvenience. So if you're going somewhere where there's very limited parking or no parking, just take public transit or take a taxi. It'll save you from the chance of getting a ticket. And that's basically it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.